Welcome back to our Sailrite workbench. Today, we're gonna be talking about a topic that every sewer needs to know about, thread. We got many requests for a thread selection guide. You guys asked, so we answered. There are four main categories for deciding what thread to get for your project. We're gonna walk you through each category so that by the end of this video, you can be a thread expert. Let's get into it. First thing you have to decide on is weave. Thread is woven and spun in different ways. The way in which it is woven will affect how it behaves as you sew. The two weaves are S-twist and Z-twist. Z-twist, also known as left-twist thread because it twists to the left, is the most common thread weave and is standard for almost all single needle sewing machines. It's also known as standard stitch thread, which is what we sell here at Sailrite. S-twist, also known as right-twist thread or reverse twist, is used in double needle sewing machines for embellishments and decorative stitches. When thread passes through your sewing machine, extra twist is applied to the thread by your machine. It's crucial to choose the right thread twist for your machine, because if you don't, the machine can actually end up untwisting the thread, which will make it shredded and have weak seams. The second thing you have to decide on is the fiber type of your thread. There are four: polyester, nylon, monofilament, and lifetime. We'll start with polyester. Polyester is known for its strength, durability, and low shrinkage and stretch. For these reasons, it's the most common thread for outdoor applications. Polyester thread comes in a variety of colors to match your fabric, but the colors will fade to white over time in the sun. For those reasons, we recommend using a UV-treated polyester thread for outdoor cushions and upholstery, sails, awnings, or anything that will have a prolonged exposure to sunlight. All outdoor polyester thread that Sailrite carries is UV-treated, ensuring that the thread will last as long as possible. Polyester is also the material for general purpose home thread like Coats Dual Duty XP. These threads are lighter in weight and are not treated for extra UV resistance. They are ideal for crafts, drapery, and a variety of lighter home sewing projects. Next, we have nylon thread. Nylon is one of the strongest synthetic threads in use today. It has a high strength to size ratio and is also known for its flexibility and stretch. The high strength of nylon makes it ideal for heavy fabric use in home decor. The added elasticity is also ideal for upholstery applications. Although nylon is a great general purpose thread, we do not recommend it for outdoor applications. Moving on to monofilament. This thread is a type of single ply non-twisted nylon thread that is strong and clear. It resembles and feels like a fishing line, so you don't want to use it for garment sewing in which the thread will rub against your skin. It comes in different weights suitable for various indoor applications. Monofilament is strong and uniform with a high resistance to abrasion, but it lacks flexibility. Because it's clear, it is useful when you want invisible seams, such as with leatherwork, furniture, upholstery, and quilting. Lastly, there is lifetime thread, also known as PTFE. This thread is synthetic and is engineered to be unaffected by UV rays. We carry two brands of lifetime thread, Tanera and Sailrite. Both of these brands carry a lifetime guarantee and will outlast the fabric in your sewing project. Unaltered by prolonged exposure to UV rays, pollution, chemicals, weather, and more, lifetime threads are recommended for projects that will be mostly or permanently outdoors. Lifetime threads carry a lot of performance benefits, but they're a little bit more pricey than other types of thread. They can be a little trickier to sew with than more traditional thread materials, so keep that in mind when deciding between a lifetime thread and a UV-treated polyester. Now that you understand thread weaves and fiber types, we can move on to thread size and thickness. Now, a thread's thickness is actually measured in its weight and not its diameter. This is because the thread is spongy and the diameter is not able to be measured accurately. Generally, as a thread's size increases, so does its strength. The most common thread size designations are tex, denier, weight, and commercial sizes. Thread size or thickness is based on a ratio of a fixed length of thread to its weight. Tex uses the weight in grams of 1,000 meters of thread. Denier also measures thread at a fixed length. It is the weight in grams of 9,000 meters of thread. Commercial size uses set sizes from the thread's denier divided by 10. V69 is the heaviest commercial thread that is recommended for home sewing machines, but make sure to check your machine guidebook for specifics of your machine's abilities. For example, the UltraFeed can handle threads up to V92. The last category we have is cone versus spool. Cones and spools are the two most common thread feeding systems. Cones hold much more thread than spools and are used for heavier weight threads. Spools hold lighter threads, especially used for home sewing. You'll also notice that on the cones of thread sold at Sailrite, the thread is cross-round, whereas spools of thread are stack-wound. The way that thread is wound affects how it is sewn and whether the cone or spool sits on or next to the sewing machine. Stacked thread spools are placed on a vertical spool pin and sits on the top of your sewing machine. The thread unwinds parallel with the top of the spool as you sew. Larger cones pair with the thread stand that has a crook or hook at the top. The thread loops around the crook so that the thread pulls straight up off the cone as you sew. This feeding method adds an extra twist to the cone of thread, increasing the thread strength and easing tension problems. Using either one of these wound threads in the wrong way will result in thread tangling, breakage, and tension issues. Once you determine a thread for your project, you will need to choose a needle. The goal for choosing the right needle is to ensure that the eye of the needle is 40% larger than the thread. Now, since this can be a tricky thing to determine, we created a handy thread and needle recommendation guide to answer all of your specific questions. We will link that in the description below, so make sure to check it out. Now, there are a few thread questions that you guys asked that we wanted to answer here at the end of our video. Someone asked about how to know when the thread is too large for the sewing machine tension unit. Now, there are two ways to test this, either by trial or through the technical. Trial will require test sewing in increasing sizes until you can't tension the thread anymore. The technical way to determine this is to refer to your guidebook. Next, someone asked how to use different thread weights for the same stitch line when stitching leather. So if you're looking to have a more prominent top thread weight, then you can pair a thicker top thread with a smaller bottom thread. You can only ever do this with the next size thread down or up. For instance, if you wanted a V138 thread on the top, then you can go down to a V92 in the bobbin, but no lower than that. That's a pretty comprehensive guide to sewing machine thread. So we hope this has been helpful for you guys in confidently choosing the right thread for your projects. And if you want to learn more, we've linked some additional resources in the description below, so make sure to check those out. And if you haven't already, make sure to subscribe to our channel so that you can stay up to date on all of our latest videos. By subscribing, you will also be joining our DIY community, where you can see community posts where you can give your input on upcoming videos. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you guys next time.